Welcome friend in Study Buddy channel, myself Professor K.S. Banker, and today we will discuss about the PERT method. So the basic techniques in project management are two, CPM and PERT. CPM is critical path method and PERT is project evaluation and review technique. Now we'll understand the PERT by the difference between the CPM and PERT. So the PERT and CPM are alike in most respect except for few extra modification incorporated into the PERT, and that is not found in CPM method. The CPM was developed for scheduling maintenance shutdown. It is based on an assumption that the project activity times can be estimated accurately without any variation, whereas the PERT was developed for scheduling the uncertain time estimate activities. PERT allows randomness in the activity times, and that's why it is called PERT is a probabilistic model, because here there is always randomness in the activity times. There is not a fixed activity time is there. That's why we are considering PERT as a probabilistic model. CPM is used for repetitive job, while PERT is used for non-repetitive jobs such as research and development, and the example are software development. In CPM, activity time is always fixed, or you can say that the single activity time, while in PERT, three activity time estimate. In CPM, it is based on the assumption that the project activity times can be estimated accurately without any variation, while in PERT, it is based on the assumption that when the CPM with single time estimate is unreliable, this modified method provides estimated project time. In PERT method, always activity time follows the beta distribution. So in this figure you can see this distribution is called beta distribution, in which here probability of occurrence, and on this x-axis possible duration is there, and the curves like this. This is a beta distribution curve, or this is also called the standard normal distribution curve. Here this is the optimistic time, that is known as TO. At the middle, this is called TM, most likely time, and at this side this is called pessimistic time, that is known as TP. So in PERT, always three time has given: optimistic time, that is known as TO, most likely time, that is TM, and pessimistic time, TP. Okay, so here optimistic time is a short time. Pessimistic time is a longer time for that particular activity, and the most likely time is the average time of that particular activity. So this is the in PERT, the time estimates follow the beta distribution. Now you can just visualize this difference. CPM, it is a critical path method. PERT, project evaluation and review technique. In CPM is used for repetitive job. We had discussed about this. One thing, CPM is a activity oriented, and PERT is event oriented. Okay. Now, in project evaluation and review technique, there are three times are given in every example. That is optimistic time that we had seen in the previous slide, most likely time or most likely value that is represented by TM, and pessimistic time that is represented by TP, and optimistic time can be represented by TO. So in PERT method there is always three time are given in the example: optimistic time, most likely time and pessimistic time. So optimistic time is what? The minimum time required, the minimum time required for completion of the activity as per the predetermined condition. Okay, so minimum time, if you consider any activity and you consider that that activity will finish in this minimum time, so that time is called optimistic time. And most likely time is what? The time of activity, time an activity will take if executed under the normal condition. Means average time is there, that is called most likely time. And the pessimistic time means what? The maximum time that activity will take under the worst condition. Okay, if any worst condition is there, at that time if you consider the maximum time due to that worst condition, if your activity will finish in the maximum time, so that time is called pessimistic time. Okay. Now, you have to just memorize the two formula for calculation of PERT method. So here you have to calculate the mean time, or that is known as expected duration, and it is represented by TE. So TE can be calculated by these equations: optimistic time plus 4 times most likely time plus pessimistic time divided by 6. So from this equation you will get the mean time or expected duration. And another is variance, sigma square. So variance can be obtained by the equation TP, pessimistic time minus optimistic time divided by 6 whole square. So this will give you a variance. Variance means what? Variance is nothing but a spread. Suppose this is your normal distribution curve or beta distribution. So here suppose this is your mean, so around this mean how much your data is spread, that is called variance. How much your data is vary around this mean is your variance. Okay, so up till now, if you have any doubt, then please comment me in my comment box. In the next video lecture, we will see the example of PERT method. Thank you very much, all of you.